Hey everyone, I'm Sam with Rokoko, and in this video we're going to be taking a little in-depth look at how to do mocap cleanup in Rokoko Studio. So this is just, you know, 30 seconds of work that will make a huge difference when it comes to the quality of your motion capture, and this is the same cleanup that will work for SmartSuit Pro 2, or for Rokoko Vision, or Mocap, or any motion capture that's made within Rokoko Studio. Let's get into it. So here I have a take I did, again, using my SmartSuit Pro 2 and my smart gloves, and this looks great right off the bat, right? You can see that if we click this little footlocks box down here, we can visualize our foot contact in the scene. Down at the bottom of the window, you can see our actual foot contact keyframes. Again, blue for the right foot and green for the left. These keyframes are such a big part of the UI because foot contact is a super important part of the way Rokoko motion capture is processed in Rokoko Studio. There are some small things that we can do. You can see, for instance, right here, when we do our little jump, if we toggle on our foot locks here, you can see our left foot, right, should come down. Let me just correct that, and we can make this a little bit better. However, there are many instances where perhaps I wouldn't do any cleanup here at all because this looks really good. Again, depending on what I need this for. Maybe I can just crop out the feet, or, you know, even without cropping out the feet, like, this looks pretty great. Again, if we wanted to fix some of this oddness here, we could just delete a few of these keyframes and maybe leave it at that. Looks great, right? However, let's look at another take that's a little bit less pristine. Okay, so in this take, I'm doing a lot more jumping, some jumping jacks, I'm doing a lot more movement, and Rokoko Studio is having a harder time keeping up. And if you check out the timeline again, you can see that sometimes Studio thinks my feet are on the ground when they're actually off, or vice versa. And that's not unexpected, right? Again, sometimes Rokoko Studio will have trouble getting the correct foot contacts, and this cleanup process is a key and essential part of getting your really good motion capture that you would expect from Rokoko. But this happens, right? This is a part of the process, and it'll just take us less than a minute to clean this up and get it looking better. So the first thing I can do is just, we want to focus in on these jumping jacks, right? So I will grab this slider and just kind of zoom in, and then I can move throughout the timeline either by moving the slider, or I can grab actually the timeline itself and just drag it around on this top part right here. But then when I actually go down and click my playhead, I can move through and we can start editing. There are a couple ways that we can edit foot contact keyframes in Rokoko Studio. The first one is just by dragging the end of the keyframe. So, you know, we can see right here that right at this point, our feet are going off the ground, but Rokoko Studio thinks that my right foot is still on the ground, so I can just drag this guy back. So we can just drag the ends of the keyframes to adjust them, right? I'll do that for right here as well. And we can move this guy as well. Already looking better. Another thing that we can do is add a keyframe. So if I just click on any empty space, there we go. We have a new keyframe added in, and I can adjust this one down right here. And the other thing we can do, and I'm gonna do that this here, is we can move the entire keyframes themselves by just dragging them. So this actually looks pretty good. So I'm gonna leave this like this. But then if we skip ahead, you can see that we have this weird one right here. If we right click, we can remove a segment, and there you go. Those are the main tools for manipulating the keyframes. So let's go through quickly now, and I will again do this in real time to kind of show you how quick you can achieve these results. So right here, you can see our foot actually lands right here, and I'm kind of just being able to tell that through context, right? You can see that my foot is landing and hitting the ground, kind of, boom, right? And then right here, and that looks pretty good. I can maybe fix this. It looks like we don't have keyframes right here at all, so I'm just gonna add two. And I will just move these over a little bit, boop. And then again, they come off. And we can extend that one a little bit. And there you go. Looks incredible, right? So just a few seconds, and we have a completely different result that is much more in line with our actual performance. Another thing that I usually will go through and do is just get rid of these small keyframes. A lot of times you'll see keyframes that are, sometimes they're even smaller than this. They'll be like little tiny stripes. And usually those are mistakes. Usually you're not doing a foot contact that is that quick. So I'll go through and I just delete these usually. You know, I'll see them throughout the timeline and I'll just kill off any stragglers. And then the other thing that I did right here, and you can see some wonkiness, is I kind of brushed my foot along the ground, right? And one thing that, again, Rokoko Studio doesn't like, because it depends so much on foot contact, is sliding your feet. Rokoko Studio really doesn't like you to slide your feet along the ground. And if you do slide your feet along the ground, like I'm doing right here, even though my foot technically touched the ground, I can get a little artistic with my keyframe editing here. It's true, my right foot touches the ground as it swings by, right? But I don't want Rokoko Studio to do this, so I'm just gonna remove this segment because my foot is acting like it's not touching the ground, right? And if we just go through and clear some of that, it'll make everything look a lot better. You can see here again, maybe I would reduce this keyframe back a little bit because I want this right foot to come up off the ground and slide, right? So we hope you found this useful. You can check out our YouTube channel for more tutorials that cover cleanup, that cover retargeting, that cover live streaming. And I'm also live at 11 a.m. PST on Thursdays on YouTube. Come and ask me questions. You know, if you're running into issues with this, come and ask me. We'll sort through it together. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.